warm welcome everyone. Today we will discuss about the apoptotic bodies as well as fill in the blanks of both the pathways which I have given you in the previous video. So let's start. So we know that after receiving a death signal, a cell will undergo morphological changes and finally form an apoptotic bodies. The details of the morphological changes and this diagram is in previous video of apoptosis. So if you haven't watched them yet, I have shared the link in the I button and the description box. Go and check the details there. So finally, there is a formation of apoptotic bodies and we have to look at the certain points regarding these bodies. The first point is that the cell membrane of this apoptotic body remain intact, means there is no damage to the cell membrane. As membrane is intact, there will be no leakage of the intracellular content in the interstitial fluid. And these apoptotic bodies are effectively enveloped by the macrophages by the process of endocytosis. So there will be no inflammation in the case of apoptosis. But in the necrosis, this is opposite. The cell burst, there will be leakage of all the intracellular contents and it will trigger the inflammatory process. Now you must be wondering how the macrophage come to know that I have to eat this cell or this apoptotic body. So we have to find out the answer to this question. So the answer to this question is the change in the cell membrane polarity. So to understand this point, we have to look to the normal cell which has a normal cell membrane. So in a normal cell plasma membrane, there is asymmetrical distribution of the carbohydrates, lipids and the proteins. Such an asymmetry is also seen in the distribution of the phospholipids. The choline containing phospholipids are on the outer leaflet of the lipid bilayer, which are basically neutral in nature. Whereas the negatively charged amino acid containing phospholipid such as phosphatidylserine is present on the inner leaflet of the lipid bilayer. This asymmetry is maintained by the proteins present in the plasma membrane. Now, during apoptosis, the activation of the caspase occurs. This caspase will act on these proteins present on the plasma membrane and cause their degradation. So now, this asymmetry can't be no longer maintained. As a result, the negatively charged phosphatidylserine is on the outer leaflet now and it will produce an eat me signal which will be detected by the macrophage. So this is how the macrophage came to know that I have to eat this apoptotic body. Now it's time for us to discuss this small assignment. First, we will check the answers of the extrinsic pathway. So a death signal has came as a fast ligand. This is a fast ligand. Then, as this fast ligand, the second step will be what? This fast ligand will bind to the fast receptor. This dark blue structure is the fast receptor. Now, after that, what will happen? The fast receptor will bind to the adaptor protein as well as to the procaspase 8, and there will be formation of death inducing signaling complex called as a disc. The fifth step, that this disc will cause the activation of the procaspase 8, which is the initiator caspase, and this initiator caspase finally causes the activation of the executioner caspase 3. So this is the summary of the extrinsic pathway of the apoptosis. Now we will look to the intrinsic pathway. In the intrinsic pathway, again, there is a dead signal. This dead signal will cause the activation of the pro-apoptotic protein. This pro-apoptotic protein will cause the increase in the permeability of the outer membrane of the mitochondria. This will lead to the release of the cytochrome C from the intermembrane space of the mitochondria into the cytoplasm. Now this cytochrome C will bind to the another adapter protein called as the apoptotic protease activating factor 1, resulting in the formation of apoptosome. Now this apoptosome caused the activation of the procaspase 9, which is the initiator caspase, and this initiator caspase caused the activation of the executioner caspase called as caspase 3. So this is the brief of the intrinsic pathway. If you want to know this pathways in more detail, you can check the videos I have shared in the I button and in the description box. So this is the end of this video. Soon we will start cardiovascular physiology and also an amazing series of long answer questions which are frequently asked in the university examinations. So make sure you have subscribed the channel and shared it. Till then, keep learning.